What's going on, guys? It's been a while. I haven't been uploading on YouTube. Been trying to grind World War II. It's been a rough year. Some average placings. Haven't even won a tournament yet, but what can you do? All in all, we're just having fun at the end of the day, so that's all that really matters. And speaking of fun, this is something that I like to do in my free time, as you guys may have noticed. I love cars. I'm all about the feel of driving, you know, the feel of the drive. And pretty much before this, I had a GT4. And now, guys, I got a 2018 Miami Blue GT3. Check it out. So I got it in manual. It also comes in PDK automatic, but I had to get the manual. You guys knew I had a GT4 before this. So wanted to keep the same theme, just wanted more power, and that's why I wanted this car. Pretty much the difference between a 0.1 GT3 and a 0.2 GT3 is a lot of things, but visually, just looking at it from the front, just looking at it from the outside, there's a couple differences. One is the front bumper. Right here, they've sort of reshaped the air intakes. And on the 0.2, it's more like slanted. It's more like sharp angles. 0.1 is like curved. So you got these two huge, massive air intakes, and you got these black spoiler end caps. So the rear tail lights are a little bit different as well. There's sort of like these cutouts right here. And then I'm pretty sure something is different in that, you know, area of the booty. Okay, so this color, which is Miami blue, I wanted to sort of go with like a blue and a yellow on it, and I wanted a color that wasn't available on the 0.1 GT3s. There's a color option which is paint to sample, and those are pretty much like ultra rare colors, you know, like one-off colors. And this was sort of like a production color that was only offered on the 0.2 GT3. And that's, you know, obviously I love light blue. I always have. I didn't want to get another black car. I think that would have been my third. I had a black M4, a black GT4. If I would have got black on this, which it does look good, but you know, I'm so glad I went with this color option. These big bad boys right here, those are the real deal. Okay, actually, any Porsche brakes are really the real deal. I think these are actually Brembos, but they, all their cars, I'm pretty sure it's because of how light the car weighs that the brakes feel so amazing. But pretty much every single like GT car you're gonna get, the brakes are gonna be good. Whether it's carbon ceramic, which are these, which last a very long time. They're actually meant for like street driving. They're not meant for street driving, but that's the best case situation, because if you track these, I think to replace the whole entire like rotors, the set, the pads, all that stuff is, I think it's like upwards of like 15 grand. So pretty much if you drive on the street, you'll never wear these down. So that's why I got them. I'm mainly doing street driving. There is gonna be a bunch of track videos. I've actually did a lot of track stuff in the GT4 that I didn't really show you guys last year, but expect lots of track videos of this to come. We're in Texas right now, so middle of the summer, no one goes to tracks here, because right now I think it's 7 p.m. It's probably 100 degrees, and you know, around like 3 to 4 is probably like 110. So it's just simply too hot to take this to the track. So gotta wait for fall, gotta wait for spring, and I think people even do it in the winter here. So I think that's really cool. But yeah, so as you guys can tell, lots of blue went with yellow. So check this out. Yellow seat belts. That's a towel. That's a towel, don't worry about that. It's like that much, right? That much. So I also got the key to match. Got the white gauges right here as well. Pretty much I like, oh yeah, and this little panel right here, that was an option. Don't know why. But pretty much I like everything that I got on this, except for this piece right here was just basically a piece of plastic before, and you could get it to match in Alcantara. So that's what I got. Okay, so I don't really know the safety limitations or requirements or why the hell the US cars have a neck pad, but the European ones do not. I think that without that neck pad, just that exposed carbon fiber looks really good. And I think it just, the more carbon fiber, the better. That's always the case, guys. So this was the Turtle Wax unveiling of my new car, my GT3, and pretty much love everything about it. I would say the one con it has compared to the GT4 is just that it feels bigger. But in every single regard, it is, I think it's the better car. If any of you guys have the opportunity to get a GT4, I'd say go for it. But anyways, this, I waited a very, very long time. I think it was like a total of a year to get this car. Absolutely love it. And yeah, I don't think I would change a thing. Always gotta go manual. Plan on taking care of this car with Turtle Wax. They have amazing car care products. And especially for someone like me, who pretty much, I'm either gaming hard or I'm driving this to get errands done. There's no in between. Maybe go to the gym, you know, growing a little gut right here, but gotta get rid of it. So driving this to the gym, running errands, getting coffee, you know, pretty much set myself up to game hard. Whenever I got free time from gaming, this is sort of my escape from that. And yeah, just sort of something I have fun in. This is a hobby to me. This is something that, you know, I use to kind of clear my head. You know, if I'm frustrated from online scrims or something like that, I'll just, you know, take this baby out. So, but other than that, guys, thank you guys for watching. I will be planning on uploading a lot. I know I've been saying this, guys, but to be honest, the last two Call of Duties have not been up to par in terms of like fan expectations. But you guys have just played the Black Ops 4 beta, and I think that that was sort of, I don't want to say it's a hit, because then you guys will quote me in a year's time and make me look like a, feel like an idiot. But I think the Black Ops 4 beta was actually really good, and I think that next year is going to be a great year for Call of Duty, and I think it's going to be a great year to drive this baby around. I can't wait to get you guys some track videos. We got to get back to Call of Duty. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed. On top of a parking garage right now, the offices are right there. It's time to get back to gaming. Oh.